the presence of God to move. You need to start expecting to see miracles and signs and wonders. That's the thing. We see so many people that they're not expectant anymore. They just come to church and they just go through the memo. They just go through the motions and they're not expecting anymore. And that's the most dangerous place that you can get in, is saying, God, there's nothing else. There's nothing more. God, there's nothing more else that you have for me. You know, I've already been at my high point in life. You can't do anything else with me anymore. When you feel like that, that is when God is about to break through. When you are at your lowest, that is when God is about to show his power and his might. So do not give up. I have seen too much to say that this generation does not want the power of the Holy Ghost. I've been in too many services. I've seen too much to hear that this generation is dead. This generation still wants a move in the Spirit. This generation is still hungry. I am still hungry. I'm still expecting to see the God's glory revealed on this earth. You cannot tell me that God does not have a plan for this generation. We hear this verse all the time, but it is so true. Joel 2:28. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. I totally believe that we are in the last days. I believe that it is time to rise up. Then again, I have to think, there still is a generation. There are still people in my generation who believe in holiness. We still believe holiness to be God's standard of living for his people. Sanctification is right. I am saved, sanctified, and filled with heaven's sweet Holy Ghost. And there is nothing that's going to stop it. And there's nothing that's going to push it out of me. There is no one that can tell me that his spirit is not real. There's a song that says, I'm one of them Holy Ghost believers. I know about the gifts and signs, and I've seen too much already to change my Pentecostal mind. And that is truly how I believe about it. I am Pentecostal through and through, fifth generation Church of God, and I do not believe that God is done with this generation. And God is not done with the Church of God. There's still people who are hungry, and there's still people who are expecting to see his glory revealed on this earth. It's time for us to absorb the good of the land. It's time for us to rise out of our sleep and to rise out of our slumber and get us something to eat. I believe that this is the day and age where we are supposed to eat and drink of the bread of life. If we are supposed to thirst for him, we're supposed to hunger for him. And I pray that there is a hunger that is birthed inside of each and every one of us tonight. I pray that this generation will arise again. I believe that it is time for us to rise up. I believe that it is time to sound the alarm, for us to get up and for us to march again like a mighty army that we are. I truly believe that the Spirit of the Lord is about to be revealed. I believe that there are people who are going to stand up. They're going to say, go ahead, turn the furnace up. Turn the furnace up high. We are not going to bend and we are not going to bow. I refuse to bow to the idols of this world. I refuse to bow to the gods of this age. I will not bow. I will stand firm my ground and I will forever proclaim the praises of the King. So much for this day. I thank you so much for everything that you've done. God, I pray right now, Lord, that you would stir our hearts once again. Lord, I pray that revival would stir in our hearts. Lord, I pray that we would eat the good of the land again, Jesus. God, I thank you, Father. Lord, that when our prayers seem like they are a bother, Lord, that's when you see that we are about to break through. God, I pray for women to break through in this house tonight. God, I pray that our prayers will be answered. Lord, dreams that have been, Lord, that have been covered away, God. Lord, dreams that have been pushed under the bed. Lord, I pray that you would rise up those dreams again. Lord, I pray that you would cause us to prophesy. Lord, I pray that you would cause us to rise up like the mighty women of God that we are. Lord, I pray that you would speak to us, Father. Lord, I pray that your spirit would be so strong in our lives every single day. Lord, whatever you put our hand to in Jesus' name, it would prosper. God, I thank you so much for all of these women. Lord, I pray that you would bless them. Lord, I pray that you would multiply their works, Jesus. Lord, we praise you and we thank you for everything that you're doing. And it's in your name that we pray. Amen.
I was so timid. But after the Holy Ghost come up on me, he gave me a holy boldness. Can you say amen? And I really have to get the flowing in the Spirit before I can do anything. And most of us do. You'd be surprised how close me and this daughter has been here tonight. She was in one place and I was in another. But I want you to know I've been talking to God all night, all day. Glory to God. I can't get no rest in my soul. houses and a catfish lake. And here we was, retirement agents. We had planned to travel. We couldn't travel with all that work. Hallelujah. We had a son that got married during that time. We gave him the old farmhouse. And he was over trying to take care of that. And they was both working together. Plus they was servicing other people's land. But I said all this to say that. Thank God, God is a big God.
Amen.
If you need something from him tonight, he just said to give you $1 million if you had 25 cents.
Yeah, that's right.
Why not?
That's right.
Why not? If you really need it. And when she began to talk tonight, I said, Lord, how close we are together. How close we are together. But I tell you, over the period of years, God told me a long time ago, he said, I'm going to use you. You will be a source of which you bring in a lot of your families like that. Friend, you might not have the opportunity if you don't have things right with God tonight. You better get it together.
That's right.
Hallelujah. It's got to come together.
Yeah.
It's not what you've done today or what you've done yesterday, but it's how it is with you today.
Right.
The minute he calls you.
Right.
I tell you, I get down in the mother world as a long time. And I said, God, I know you took my husband. Now you said you'd be my father, you'd be my mother, you'd be my sister, you'd be my brother. Or whatever I need, you said you'd be it. And after a while, I can get to feeling a little better. I tell you, God is so good.
Yes,
God
amen. Is. Amen.
It's time we hold our torch high.
Yes.
And allow our praises to echo and no longer be silent.
For this is the night I let go of me completely and take hold of you. Not my will, but my will be done, O Lord.
I'm open, come and fill me. Your presence is real. take it.